The following is a presentation of TFNN. Trade What You See with Larry Pesavento. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648 or internationally at 727-445-1044. Now, Larry Pesavento.
Looking good, Billy Ray. Feeling good, Lewis. I hope I'm coming through okay. Would you give me a quick 10-4 if you can hear me? I think it's all right, but you just never know in the technical world of computers today. Doesn't look like things are the way they should be today, folks. Shut the front door and raise the rent. I guess no one can hear me. Anyway, we'll see here. All right, let's double check, see what's wrong. Oh, boy. Let's see. Okay, I don't know why it's coming in low. I've got it set as high as I can get. Let me double check something here just to be safe. Just to be safe here. We'll get this thing going here. Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. Any better? Any better? Wow, I don't know what's wrong, but everything's the same here in La La Land, but let's just double check here. Is that any better? Testing 1, 2, 3. Testing 1, 2, 3. It's hard when you're coming through from Star Trek. Wow, this is not very good. Okay, we'll do with what we can, folks. You know, the trouble is when you get a new G7, you just never know what the technical things are going to be like. Folks, we've had a couple of big things happen over the weekend. One, of course, is the fact that we have a situation where the Bitcoin is getting ready to break down again. It looks like it's getting ready to break big time. Let's bring this up because I think it's got a chance here to get down to that level that we're looking for, which is way down around 3,800. That's only about 3,000 bucks from where it is now. And when you think we went from 19,000 to where we are now, the big ABCD structure on that comes in at that level. This is really not about Bitcoin. It's about blockchain technology. Whether that's going to continue or not, you know, we'll have to wait and see. But right now, it looks like it is something that should be in the future and looks pretty good. I rely on my good friend, John Jameson, because he really understands this better than anybody I know, and he gives me a pretty good idea of what's happening, you know, in these markets. I wanted to talk just a little bit about the coffee market. I haven't traded coffee since Hector was a pup. But let's just take a look here, because last week we made a pretty significant bottom here in coffee. It was down at the exact 1.618 expansion. And if you'll notice, that goes back well over 18 months. It's a beautiful pattern, too, because you have multiple ABCD patterns forming. The key is that it must not go below $100. And we're seeing pretty much the same pattern potentially in sugar, but it's still a little bit early. But there's one other market that really is in the news a lot that we've talked about before that we should mention here, and that is the market for Elon Musk's Tesla. As you recall here, about a week or so ago when it was trading up at that ABCD pattern at 386, which was a perfect ABCD pattern, by the way, you know, we've broken down and we noticed we had important support there at that 325 level, which was a 61% retracement. And, of course, we mentioned that it was going to gap below that on Friday, and it certainly did. And now we're trading, folks, believe it or not, we're trading at nearly down $100. We are down $100 a share. That's 30% in 2 weeks. Something big has happened to this stock. Now, if you'll go back and look at the stock back in February, you'll notice that we went from 360. We dropped another $100. We dropped $110 all the way down to 245, which was a major bottom. So we're ready to take this C point out from July, which is at the 283 level. The last price I saw on Tesla was at 286 this morning, and with another gap down, we could easily do that. Now, there's some news that is causing that. The big problem is no one is telling us what that news is, and that's part of being a technician is you just follow what the prices are telling you, because the inside folks are certainly not going to tell you what is going on there, but there's certainly something huge going on, and the bears are definitely in control. Pay attention to that one, because it's a very, very interesting pattern. Now, I did post the chart for the DAX this morning. As you can see, we're down near a Gartley pattern. We should be getting a little bit of bounce like we have in the DAX, but not too much. The FTSE chart was unavailable to me this morning, so I was not able to bring that to your attention. But I wanted to bring two things to your attention. Since we were talking about the coffee, I wanted to bring up the chart of Starbucks, which is the really long-term chart here, the weekly chart here of Starbucks, because it relates to the price of coffee. You can see here about 8 weeks ago, well, about 10 weeks ago, we made a 78% retracement down there at $47 a share. We're now up at the 382 retracement there at $53 a share, but it is in a very, very long consolidation going back from 2015 to where we are right now. Any move below 45 would probably take this market down to about $28 a share without too much trouble, but that's a stock, and I don't do those very often, but someone asked me the question because it related to the coffee, and you can notice because, you know, the price of coffee has gone down, but, you know, if the price of coffee is going down, that's the product that they sell. The price of Starbucks should be going up because their price-earnings ratio should be going higher. That's what it makes sense to me, but, you know, sometimes it doesn't make sense to everybody else, and that's what really counts. Now, I wanted to mention just a little bit about the commodity markets on a long-term basis. What we're going to look at here is the DBA, which is the ETF, basically, for livestock and futures. This covers the grains and the livestock market. You'll notice that the big ABCD pattern is complete now, but what's important, folks, look at the low from 2008. And remember, that 2008, that's when the market turned down. And so, you know, this market doesn't pay any attention to what's going on in the stock market, but we're completing a big ABCD pattern in these things, so we're going to see if that's going to be the case or not. Now, part of this agri-futures ETF is hogs and also in the cattle market, and cattle, of course, have been acting very, very bullish all along, and we've had a tremendous move in the hog market, you know, that has been highlighted, of course, when we were watching the December hog contract when it was down at that three drive to a bottom pattern through our good friend Rich Anderson. He mentioned to us that $44 was pretty much the cost of production in Christmas hogs, and you can see where we are now. We're a good $12 a pound higher in December hogs right now with the big gap up. Now tomorrow, hopefully, and I'm saying this with a great deal of trepidation, that we're going to have a joint guest tomorrow with Rich Anderson of Anderson Capital Management and Cy Monley of Sylvius Financial. We're going to be talking about the livestock market and the grain markets and how they related to tariffs and all the other things that are going on, and some of these things related to the U.S. dollar along with the supply-demand situation, because we had a very bearish report and now soybeans have rallied back and have made a 78% retracement of a previous high. So a lot of those things are coming in, you know, very, very closely. I just saw the price of Yahoo cross the tape here at $2.90, so evidently $2.85 was so far the low today. So that's going to be. So let's take a break here, 877-927-6648.
The TAS Profile Scanner Plus, developed by John Logan and his team, is a standalone piece of software that can change the way you trade. Let the TAS Profile Scanner work for you by scanning over 5,000 financial instruments such as stocks, ETFs, commodities, futures, and Forex. Right now, you can get a 30-day free trial to the TAS Profile Scanner Plus right at TFNN.com. And when you sign up, you gain instant access to John Logan. Logan's most recent webinar, How Price, Volume, and Time Make Market Profiles So Unique. This hour-long webinar with John Logan will walk you through the most powerful features of the scanner and how you can use it to become a more successful and profitable trader. You pay absolutely nothing for 30 days while you try out this software risk-free.
free. For more information on the TAS Profile Scanner and to get your 30-day free trial today, visit the front page of TFNN.com.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video, giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com. Call now, toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-873-7618.
Back, folks, and hopefully we got a better connection that we have going on here. We'll have to wait and see. Anyway, we'll be able to work better, but boy, I'm a world to try to do this. Let's move on with some of the things we talk about. Continue talking, whether you can hear me or not. Not positive. You never know. Okay, let's take a quick look here at a couple of these markets. Folks, most of this move that we've had in stock, in fact, all of it, January, has been related to fixed base stock. Amazon, which is better than 36%. Okay, oh dear. I don't move much as it is anyway. 36% in Amazon, and the rest of it, of course, is Apple, Microsoft, Netflix, followed by Google and also Facebook. But the problem is, folks, with Facebook and one other stock, look incredibly bearish. Just look at the stock of Facebook. This is an extremely bearish stock. You'll notice that after we made the top up here, we had the island reversal up there at that $2.18 a share. We gapped down just a little bit the next day, down about 20%. Hopefully you got the message, sell it on the close that day, as we say tongue-in-cheek. But the key here is we had basically a 30% rally off of that, and we've gone nowhere over the last 2 weeks. But that is nothing compared to what the stock looks like at Twitter. Now, this might be the biggest bull trap ever, but I don't think that it is. If you'll take a look at this, stock on Twitter. Look at this, folks. We had the same type of a situation in Twitter. We had the big ABCD, but that gave you plenty of time to get short up in that 45, 46 level. Then we had the big gap down around 42. But after we hit the bottom, we've been going sideways for 3 weeks, and that is extremely bearish. We can't even make a simple ABCD correction here. And not only that, but it's sitting right at the 78. Any move below 30 on the stock will give it a price level somewhere between 22 and 18, and that's not a good sign for Twitter. Maybe the president will stop tweeting and the stock will start to go down because of that. But who knows? All I'm saying is that Twitter stock does not look bullish. if people think that's good accumulation, they might be right. And the, you know, and the risk here is certainly very small, because anything below $30 a share, you certainly wouldn't want to be in this. But it doesn't have anything positive to look at as far as that. There's one stock that is, you know, absolutely has no top at all, at least not yet, and that is the stock of Apple. I believe we hit $220 a share this morning in Apple, and that exceeds the ABCD that came in around $216. But the market just continues to go higher, and you know, there's just no selling and abating to that. But you know, that can stop very quickly. But of the stocks that we look at, none of these have really gone anywhere other than the Apple. Amazon is still in a negative environment here. You'll be able to see it here in just a second. It has actually made a very interesting pattern that we're seeing in the Dow Jones Industrial Average, and that is the expanding triangle pattern that Gartley talked about in pages 200 to 240 in his book, Profits in the Stock Market, 1937. That's an expanding triangle, also known as the reverse point wave. It has a beautiful symmetry there. If Amazon gets above 1913, this would be a failed pattern, and we could continue to go a lot higher if that is the case. If we look at the Google is even more bearish than the Amazon, of course. If you look at the Google, after we made the big ABCD pattern, you'll notice on the back in the February-March period, you see a perfect ABCD pattern coming in there on March the 26th. The market rallied up to a 61% retracement, backed off to a 78% retracement, and then it was off to the races to the tune of about $350 a share. And we made the big ABCD up there, you know, perfectly at the 1270 level. Now we're trading around a little above 1200. We just completed an ABCD pattern in Google on Friday. As you can see, it came in right at the 50% level. So that is very strong support here in Google, which tells us that maybe the Google has some more to the upside. But anything below 1180 in the Google, that would tell us that it's most probably getting ready, you know, to move to the downside. One comment about these price levels that I give you folks. When I'm looking at price levels of support at 618 and 78% level, that's what they are. They're Fibonacci numbers and they're price support. That's nothing more, nothing less. When you have other patterns there at the same time, that leads a great deal of credence to that support. But if you don't have anything other than that, that's all you have. And you have to respect that, because if the market goes below the 61% level, it most probably will go to the 78. And below the 78, it has a probability of going down to double bottom at 1, or most probably 1.27 or 1.618. And that's why these numbers are important, because once they start to expand and contract, that's what you really need to look for. And remember, we don't really know what the market's going to do next, so the only thing that we can do is protect ourselves, you know, against ourselves. And that's the key, you know, to watching, you know, these markets and what you're looking at. You want to be able to make sure that that's what you're looking for is when you're looking at some of these things, because when you have these things lined up with all these numbers and they fail, that's telling you that it is a really big, you know, it's an incredibly important thing to be looking at. And that's what I think is you know, so very, very important. You don't always get that opportunity where you have everything coming together, but when you do, you have to pay, you know, really close attention to it. So that's basically what you want to be watching for, is these levels for support and resistance when they come in with the pattern. So you have patterns along with the support and resistance of Fibonacci lines, and then you have something that will really give you a pretty good idea of what we're watching for. Now, I wanted to cover one other stock, and of course that is the stock of Softie. Get it up here a little bit. This level right here, you'll see Microsoft also has completed a big three ABCD pattern to the upside. The key here is after we made the 135 pattern back in April, the market came up. Look at how it made a beautiful Gartley pattern at the 382. That's a very bullish Gartley pattern at the 382, and then of course it goes up, completes the ABCD pattern up here at that 110 and change level. We're trading about 108 this morning, but that pattern is also complete. So of all the FANG stocks we look at, including, well, we threw in Twitter, and we also threw in, which other one did we, well, Twitter was the only one that we threw in besides that. But the next one, of course, was the Netflix, and that one has backed off a great deal. It's backed off, you know, well over 15%. But the only one that has gone up and broken all the numbers, of course, is the big stock of them all, the $1 trillion special, which is Apple. And the key to that one is once we went above 202, which signaled that it was a $1 trillion company, it gave everybody the green light to see if it was going to be a $2 trillion company. So we'll pay attention to that. So anyway, that's what we're watching for oil.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
I'm Rick Scott, and I approve this message.
Okay, boys and girls, this is Billy Ray Robinson from the offices of Duke and Duke from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, 100 South Broad Street. We're going to talk a little bit here this morning about the U.S. dollar index. If you'll take a look at this, folks, this is the long-term weekly chart. We had that breakout to the upside above that 9450 level last week. We went right up to 9700, which was a perfect 1.27 expansion of the move coming off of early January. This is extremely important. As you can see, we're just a hair's breadth from the 61% retracement on the long-term weekly chart. But even more importantly, if we go and take a look at the euro, and that's what I think is running this market and the importance of that 113 level, you'll notice that on the weekly chart, we have made a 61% retracement from mid-April. That was 0.5 of the 135 pattern. That was very important because 0.3 and 0.5 were perfectly symmetrical in time and price. And that 61% retracement came in exactly at 113, which was the exact low. We rallied all the way up to the 114.40 level over the weekend. So far, all we've been able to back off is about 50 pips. We're back to that 114.20 level, which is a very positive sign. But this could be a very, very important spot here for the euro. I do feel very strongly that if we get below 112, we're going to be looking at a dollar index that's going to be soaring and a euro index that's going to be heading down a great deal lower. But right now, it's held that major support extremely well. Fortunately, we were watching this all week long, bringing it to your attention at that 113 level. It had a lot of things going for it. And if we take a look at it on just a little bit smaller time frame, like if we went down to a hourly chart like we do here at TFNN, we went down to the four-hour chart, and you'll notice that we had a perfect 1.618 ABCD pattern completing there that verified that that 61% retracement on the long-term weekly was, of course, very, very important. Now, what we've done thus far is we've made equal rallies. You can see here that we had an equal rally here back in late July. We had another one in mid-August, and, of course, we're having one right now. The way I would interpret this is that if we get above this 114.60 level, that would tell us that this rally has legs. And because it is a beautiful ABCD pattern from the 15th of August, which, of course, it's only about 5 or 6 days,
but it still has that capability of telling us that it has a chance to go a lot higher. That's what we're watching here, is the key level of the 114.60 level. Now, this also correlates to what we're watching in the precious metals market. You know, we saw that big move down in gold. It went below the level that we were looking at, of course, in the long-term Fibonacci level in gold. But it just, you know, when you stop and think how far gold had been coming down, it was in, you know, within 1% of that level we were looking at. But I wanted to bring this to your attention because if what's happening, what we're seeing now in the gold market is the fact that we had that really big bottom down there at that 1166 level. We had a really strong rally, then we had a 50% pullback, and that gives us an ABCD pattern taking us up to around the $1,200 level. So that's what I think we're going to be looking at, is if we get to that level and then pull back, that's going to be the key to what's going to happen to the precious metals over these next few days now, and weeks, of course. But that's what we're looking at. Now, I'm not 100% sure, but nobody else is either. The one thing that was really important, brought to our attention by one of our folks here at TFNN, kind enough to send us a chart from the Pacific Northwest, and we certainly appreciate in sending along to us. But if you take a look at this chart from the Elliott Wave Theorist, this has nothing to do with the Elliott Wave. This is basically showing you the price of gold on the top and then the price of silver on the bottom. You can see that the big divergence where silver has gone down and made a, you know, big expansion number. In fact, that number is 1.618 down there at that 1440 level in December gold. And in fact, the thing that we did last week was probably relatively smart, because we had an order to buy it down there with a relatively close stop, and it's been able to rally, you know, 35 cents since that level. So if you were able to do that, and we were doing this when it was on the air, so if you were able to buy the silver at that level, I'd put your stop at break even and you know, be like the old baseball adage, spawn, sane, and pray for rains. It's keep your stop in at your break-even level and not worry about it. But this divergence where you're noticing that non-confirmation, but you're looking at the green little typing there where it says there's only 6% bulls in the precious metals for gold and 7% for silver. Folks, it hardly gets any lower than that. So there is virtually nobody bullish besides myself and one other person, and he is anonymous. But anyway, that's what we're looking at. But if we go below that level after a substantial rally, that would be extremely bearish. But we'll have to wait. 877-927-6648.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They have been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com. TFNN has put together the finest programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 8 hours a day, starting at 9 a.m., as Larry Pesavento kicks us off with Trade What You See. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour following the Tom O'Brien Show. Swim lessons from TD Ameritrade, Thinkorswim, is now at 11 a.m., followed by Basil Chapman at 12 noon. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts. And keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN.com, educating investors.
Biotech is booming, but for how long? Whether you think the biotech bull has room to run or has run its course, trade LABU or LABD. Direction's daily S&P Biotech 3x bull and bear ETFs. Visit directioninvestments.com/biotech today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
The Bull Bear Binary Option Hour, brought to you by Nadex. Next on TFNN.
Okay, boys and girls, this is Billy Ray Robinson from the offices of Duke & Duke, 100 South Broad Street, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, experiencing what we call technical difficulties this morning, but we'll hopefully get them fixed here. We've been asked to take a look at palladium, and fortunately, the trading gods against me, I have never traded palladium before, so I don't really have what I think is an accurate chart on palladium, so I'm going to have to pass on that one, but I did hear some news on palladium this morning from Bloomberg. Really early this morning, I was double-checking to see what was going on with the Turkish currency and a few of the other things, and they mentioned that the price of palladium was at multi-layer levels because of the fact that we were going out of combustible engine cars, and that the big thing in China was that they're going to be completely devoid of combustible engine cars in about 10 years. I hope someone tells Toyota and Nissan about that, because they better switch to electrical cars pretty soon. Frankly, I don't trust anything that you can't hear when driving. So that's it. I've only ridden in one Tesla. I thought it was okay, but I didn't think it was nearly as luxurious as a Mercedes or even a Lexus or a Cadillac, as a matter of fact. But that's my two cents worth. Nothing against Elon Musk or anything like that. Now, some questions have come to my attention early this morning about Tesla. And believe it or not, folks, I really don't know what's going on in Tesla. I don't have any inside information. In fact, the only time I have gotten inside information in my 55 years of trading has been wrong. I can never remember, ever, and I mean this sincerely, I have never gotten a stock tip or inside information of any kind that ever worked out correctly. And I, that's why I'm 100% why I'm a technician, but, if someone knows I'm going to be the last person they tell about it. So that's probably what you're looking at. So I don't know anything about the politics. I mean, I know less about that than I do anything else. So anyway, but be very aware of tip givers, because tip givers are tip takers. As you remember, if you ever read the information from stock market, what was it, Reminiscence of a Stock Operator by Edwin Lefebvre, he said, don't ever be a tip taker or a tip giver, because it's usually very bad information. So one of my favorite stories of that book was from old Westlake, the guy who was always wrong, and Jesse Livermore said, always listen to that guy because he's 100%. And the guy said, yeah, but he's always wrong. He said, that's only if you take the side that he's on. So that's very, very important. But, boy, it certainly does exist, PT. If anybody doesn't believe that inside information doesn't exist, you're living in la-la land. Believe me, that's it. And that's the one thing about being a chartist, is they can't hide from you. If they're buying, prices are going up. If they're selling, prices are going lower. That's the bottom line. There's nothing else that we can look at. By the way, we're going to have... hopefully, we're going to have Norm Winsky on Friday. And tomorrow I'm going to do my very best to put together a show with Rich Anderson and also Cy Moley about the grains and also the livestock markets, because these markets have been going, really strong to the upside, and I think they're going to be getting to go higher. There's been some news out of China about the hog swine, and they've had to close the largest hog packing operation in all of China. And, folks, that is big news, whether that's related to why these Chinese people are here now, because that's the number one meat in China is pork. So it could be related to that. And believe me, hogs are very, very fragile. If you've ever been to, well, not many people have ever been to a hog farm, but it's like being in a hospital. It really is. You know, you think of when I was a kid watching the hogs wallowing out in the mud and everything, throwing slop out to them. But boy, it's not like that anymore. They're really very aware of that stuff. Anyway, chickens are pretty much the same way. We'll take a look at some of these other markets that we want to look at. There's one other market that is really, yes, they do. No question about that, Marshall. They do stink. There's no question about it. Let's take a quick look here at this Australian dollar, folks, because I think we've made a major bottom in the Australian dollar. Look at this one for a possible buy here. If you look at the Australian dollar, this is a daily chart going back over the past year. You can see you've had several ABCD patterns. The big one, notice there in red, was a 382 retracement. We've now completed an absolute perfect three drive to a bottom pattern down there 3 days ago at that 72 level. We're about one and a half handles higher right now. So if you get a pullback in that, I would certainly take a look at that. As long as we stay above 72 in this Australian dollar, we could have a pretty good rally from this level, because that large ABCD pattern, the last time you had a BC swing, it had a rally of well over three and a half handles, which is $3,500, and we're only up, one and a half handle right now, so it could have a pretty good rally from that level. So all of these currencies have made something very, very dramatic, and I think that's why we're seeing this resistance up around the that level that we're watching here in the U.S. dollar index at that 97. Now, let's go across the pond and take a look here at the British pound. If you'll notice in the last 3 months, we have a big ABCD pattern going back from June that completed down at this 126 and change level. We haven't rallied very much, but we still have a rally coming up. The problem with the British pound is something to do with the fundamentals, and I don't like to get into that, but it's related to Brexit, because if they get into a war of capital, in other words, they stop capital controls or put on capital controls between the countries of the EU, then there's going to be big problems in the British pound, and you don't want to be long the British pound if that happens, because it would be something that would be pretty, pretty dramatic. You remember what happened in Brexit. You know, we were trading at 150 when the odds were 90% that Brexit was going to fail, and look what happened. It went from 150 down to 116 and change. So when these things turn, they can turn on a dime. And that includes the stock market, folks. And we're at a level in the stock market that is extremely dangerous. But that's my opinion. Remember, that's what it is. It's an opinion, and everybody has to see what's going on here. We'll have to keep an eye on what's looking at some of these things that we're watching in the market. So keep an eye on some of these currencies, because they've hit some major, major areas in here that should be interesting from a long-term perspective for a really good rally, if nothing else. That's the main thing that we want to be seeing of what we're watching here. When we get back from the break, I wanted to spend just a little bit of time on the Canadian dollar, because that's another one that has got a very, very beautiful pattern that could be really, very, really important for the currencies over the next 4 or 5 weeks or so, because longer term, it's in a big downtrend. We've had a big, well, let's just put it up here since we've got time, and we'll discuss it when we get back. You'll see that it's made a big 135 pattern over the past 3 months. It's about as perfectly symmetrical as you can possibly get, and it looks like it's heading down towards the level, at least the 129.30 level, down another 130 pips, which would be another ABCD pattern to the downside. But even if that fails, you're looking at something that could be very dramatic, because you'll notice that it stopped exactly at the 78% level at 0.1. That was a big ABCD pattern completed that we brought to your attention there at that 133.90 level, and that's still the one that's controlling everything.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Okay, folks, let's wrap up the show here today by taking a look at the Treasury bond market. If you believe in technical analysis, you're going to keep an eye on this one because you have a beautiful head and shoulders pattern. You'll notice that the right shoulder and left shoulder are equal in time. The right shoulder is a little bit lower. That's mainly because the market is so bearish. But you do have a potential for a beautiful ABCD pattern coming up here around the 147.28, 148 level. We're a little above 145 right now, so we still got a couple more handles to go. Any weakness in the stock market, God forbid, if we were to get that, would probably get that market up to that level without any trouble. That would equal the rally that we had from May to August. You notice that we rallied, you know, from 150 all the way up to 158. That would be similar to 139 up to 148. So that would be another one that would be very, very interesting in price and time together. So that's another one that's on the watch list. It's not anywhere near close to where we're being. I did want to bring one other thing to your attention, and that is also from our good friend up in the Northwest, and that is the thing from the Elliott Wave Theorist that shows the ETFs on the bulls versus bear on the right X bull bear ratio. It's one of the highest levels ever, going back to well into 2000, I believe. And you'll notice that it's up around that 25 level. And the last time we reached that, I believe, was around 2000 from the long-term charts, as we've seen that happening over a period of time. Again, I'm going to do my very best to have Rich Anderson and Simon only on tomorrow. So far, everything is set up. Only if market conditions would change would give us an idea that we're looking at something that would make it a little more difficult as far as getting the show to go, but I think it should be okay. Technically, I'll have everything corrected by tomorrow, and I think we'll be just fine. Anyway, that's about it, folks. We'll live every day in an attitude of gratitude, and may God bless. Live every day in an attitude of gratitude, and God bless.
Folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.